Good morning, y'all. No, I look crusty. It is currently 7:45 right now, and it's May 1st. So I'm going to be taking y'all on a little trip today. We're going to be going to the hospital today for my pre-surgery checkup, basically. They said it's going to take 3 hours. So, preparing for that. Yeah. And then afterwards, got a little date with my meal. Got a little date, so after that, I'm just gonna dress good from beforehand when heading to the hospital. And then after the hospital, we're going out to eat. And then we're gonna go to Le Noche to check on pets, because we're actually gonna plan on getting a cat. I already have names, and we are already starting to get a few stuff for the cat from beforehand, so that when we do get the cat, everything will be here for the baby, for the little fur baby. Oh, I'm so excited. So, right now, I'm just gonna get ready first, and then, because my appointment is at 11, but they want me to come in for around 10:30, so I could get my hospital card and then go and check my appointment, see everything's good, my options and stuff for the laparoscopic, I think that's how you say, laparoscopy surgery. Yeah. So let me just do a little cut here of like me getting ready and stuff. So hold on. Skincare done, nice and glossy, just lashes, fix up my eyebrows, and boom, 8:14. So I'm leaving here in an hour, so I'm just gonna have maybe something small to eat, or I'm gonna get something at the metro. But yeah, we will cut to when we are at the Concordia on our way to the hospital. Hey y'all, so currently I'm at the hospital right now. It is 12:24 and everything turned out great. They said I'm healthy. All they have to do is just double check something before the surgery and I'll be ready to go. Yeah, that was actually pretty fast. This was gonna take about 3 hours, but been here for almost maybe an hour and a half, so that went pretty good. And yeah, now I'm on my way to go get some eats because your girl hungry. The only breakfast I had was that little bun that you saw in the previous video, but yeah, now we're heading to the restaurant.
This is giving you flashbacks? Huh? Got the slurp juice on deck. Huh?
Hey, drinking.
I'm so freaking dark.
Day drinking. How you feel?
Everything strong.
The slurp juice is kind of strong.
This is getting hard. This is sick to water.
My pants! So yeah, this is a restaurant we've been going to for how long now? See there, bump.
6 years.
No. 6? About 6 years, yeah. It's called Three Amigos. I know. Doesn't it sound?
It does.
But yeah, the food good though, still.
What do you say? 3 months.
Three months.
It's better than 5 guys.
You said it's better than 5 guys?
Yeah, like the name.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, when you think about it, yeah, it is in the name terms. But 3 guys is better than 5.
Did a little bit of shopping. Hey. I said we did a little bit of shopping. Went to Miniso and then went to Pharmacie. Huh? Man, you're so scared of the freaking door.
No.
Yes, you are.
Oh, damn,
pull it. That door was so hard to pull. What the hell?
I'm telling you, that's what
really? I'm recording now.
Right now? No, bus. Like, can.
Yes, we're going to see if they have bus on them thing there. Not like that, man.
No. I just want to look without a bus. Like, can.
Yes, we're going to the pet store. See you there. Where the fur babies?
That's what we do. We don't have food. They see the options, the more they get
it. Okay, but look at the price though. Shani's $300. Oh, the cat's name Shani. Oh, look though. She's right there.
Right there?
Yeah.
Oh, see there.
She's right there in the basket.
Oh, see shit. That's an unbound hill. I don't see shit.
Hey, pretty birdie. Hey, pretty birdie. Hey. 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 She poked her head out when we left. Look at her. She's so cute, man. And then they both fall. Hey, y'all. So it's actually a few days later from, yeah, your girl did that, all those parts, and then I've just been editing the clips, but I forgot to add in another part. Silly me. But today, I just wanted to go over how the day went. So the day went pretty good. We actually got a few things. While I'm talking, I'm going to be getting ready because I'm actually recording another video today. So, yeah. So, but it actually went pretty good. We actually saw the cat that we wanted. But we just have to We have to get a few more things before we can actually get her, but hopefully she is still there by the time we have to get her. And if not, you know, it's okay. You know, the cat will be with a good foster family, hopefully. And I didn't really go at the hospital. I didn't really go into much depth about what's going on. So I wanted to talk about it a bit more here while I get ready. So basically, one day I went out. Yeah, I was just working out and... No, scratch that. Let's go a little bit further back. So I think it was 2018. I was told that I had a cyst on my ovary, but they told me it was nothing. I don't even know what mirror I want to use. Okay. But yeah, they told me that the cyst, you know, it wasn't that serious. Women get cysts on the regular, and that it should go away. It should go away by the time, you know, within like maybe a few weeks, because, which is true, cysts do usually disappear on their own. But this cyst, come to find out, did not leave. So, a few years go by till maybe last year, I believe. And I'm here just regularly, you know, going about my days, not really worrying about the cyst or nothing, like, because it's been a couple of years, mind you. And she's... And my doctor just told me, oh, my doctor from before told me, oh, it'll go away, it'll be fine. And one day, I'm just working out, and I had, like, this pain on my side. And me, I didn't think nothing really much about it. I just thought that maybe, you know, I'm just ovulating, nothing too serious. You know, it'll go away, but... I noticed it was progressively, like, getting painful. And I'm like, okay, no. This shouldn't last, like, on and off, like, every other type of day. And then I just noticed that one day when I was deciding to lift weights and I got, like, this extreme pain. And I'm like, no, something's not right. Something's not right with me. So then I go, this is when I have a brand new family doctor now. And I'm asking her, like, hey, you know, I'm having this, like, pain on my side. And I don't know what it could be. And it hurts every time that I'm, like, trying to exercise or something. And then... She's like, okay, we're going to issue you an ultrasound and we're going to see what the problem could be. So they couldn't really do the regular ultrasound. They had to do a vaginal ultrasound. So I get the, I think it's called acquisition. I don't really know the name, but I get the paper to go do the ultrasound. And this is, like, in, well, let me just check my eyebrows real quick, because I don't want it to look crusty. Okay, so, yeah, I go and get the ultrasound to do at the same clinic, and I get it for the next day, and she's... Usually when it comes to, like, vaginal ultrasounds, so, like, an ultrasound, if you were to do, like, if you're pregnant, just, like, an abdominal ultrasound, they tell you to drink a lot of water. So I drank a lot of water from beforehand. I get there. They're checking me, and she's saying, okay, now I'm going to need you to finish your bladder. I'm like, okay, cool. I finish my bladder. I go to pee and empty my bladder, and then she's like, did you fully empty it? And I'm like, yes, I did. And she's like, well... I don't know if I should get the bring you to the emergency to have emergency surgery because you have a very large cyst on my fallopian tube. And I'm like, in that moment, I'm just like, what the hell? Like, what do you mean? Is it that bad? And she's like, well, it's nothing cancerous or nothing, thankfully, but it just doesn't need to be there. And it was the same cyst that I had had from 2018, and it had gotten bigger. Just never realized it until when I was lifting weights, and then all of a sudden I'm in this extreme pain. Boom, I have a 12 centimeter cyst on my left fallopian tube. So now they're wondering if I should go straight into emergency surgery to get it done with. But since I told her that my pain is not to the point where I'm not heavily breathing or anything, they're just like, okay, we're going to wait it out and see if you could schedule a surgery. So I'm like, okay, that's no problem. And I go to my family doctor, gets the information. She gets me a gynecologist so that he could tell me what's going on with my cyst. And then afterwards, it's about, I wait like maybe a month for the recommend, when she gave the paper, and I was waiting basically like a mini wait list, but it wasn't long. And then I meet up with him, and then he describes to me more about what it is. So it's a para-ovarian cyst, and typically those cysts, they're not on your egg or inside your ovary. Basically they're not inside or on the outside of your ovary. It's attached to your fallopian tube. So he was telling me that usually this is not a big situation, that I'll still be able to have kids, and there's nothing really to worry about. It's just a big old cyst that does not need to be there. So he was like, yeah, so we're gonna book your surgery for 3 to 4 months. And I think it was January of this year. Yeah, it was January of this year. And then skip to May, and I'm having my surgery on the 24th. So literally in 3 weeks, I will be having my surgery, and I will be showing more details of that as well. But yeah, and it will be my first surgery. So your girl is low-key nervous. Yeah, nervous. Yeah. And they told me, and this is when I said in the first clip about it, it is a, I don't know how they pronounce it, but laparoscopic. So they're going to be making 3 cuts, one at my belly button for the camera, and then the other 2 would be for the tools that they need to help remove the cyst from my fallopian tube. And then, yeah, it's very less, it's not super invasive, and the most of the surgery would take is an hour. And everything kind of happened so fast. I felt like these 3 months went by pretty fast, and it's like each day just made me more nervous and nervous, because obviously I know I'm gonna be okay when everything plays out. And but yo, like, having your first surgery is low-key kind of scary. Very much scary. Spooky scary. Spooky scary. You know, but I just can't wait to get that over with. But you know, the worst part about it is I can't have no fun time for 6 weeks. Yeah, no fun times. No fun time, no rainbows, nothing for 6 weeks. So your girl gonna be on bed rest for a while. I can't even go to parties. Well, maybe I could, but I can't just, I can't, like, do all the extra stuff that I do, if you know me. But kind of gotta chill for those couple of days. Couple of days, maybe weeks, I don't know, but because I'm a very, like, moving person. Yes, I don't like to just sit down and not do anything if I'm home. Like, something always got to get done in the house. If I have nothing to do outside, if I don't have anything to work on or nothing, I'm trying to, like, move around in the house and do something. I'm never really just, like, chilling. I'm always moving, so now that I'm going to have to be chilling... boring. But yeah, this is a very much new this is a very much new experience for your girl. Very new experience for me. Because, you know, I know I will be blessed well, recovery, especially too, like, since I've been working out more since January, as y'all would know from my post on Instagram, if you follow me on Instagram, I've been working out nonstop, and I heard that would help with recovery, and you know, I can't wait. Nervous, but I can't wait. Well, yeah, can't wait for that to happen and deal with that. I'm just gonna finish up my lip, and then I'll be right back. I'll be right back. Yeah, guys. So this was the end of the vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I'm trying to get used to being outside and vlogging. That was my first time, so I'm gonna slowly try to do that slowly. But if you guys did like the vlog, let me know and I'll try to do more. I will try to do more. And yeah, I just wanted to kind of go over about why I'm getting surgery, you know, how is it making me feel and all of that. So I just want to kind of go over that a little bit, and then when it's the day of, there'll be much more information. I'll show more stuff then. But, you know, this is all I had for today's video. So I hope you guys have a lovely day or night. Make sure to mind your business and drink your water. And remember that health is... You got it. I don't even got to say it. All right. Bye, y'all.